Office of Pamlico County Public Clinic, Holtz Chapel Community Center, Parkworks, Habitat for Humanity, and Goose Creek Island Community Development Center.
Yes, my name is Douglas Pearsall, here representing the Pamlico County local group of the NAACP, 5429. Again, my name is Douglas Pearsall, the president of the local chapter NAACP 5429. I have various members here, and we are in the business of just trying to do what is right and just in this world. I have my first vice chair, Sue, and Clement. Sandra Hawkins, Whitney Jones, Darrell Gibbs. And we are here to represent the all class of people in the world. We had our banquet last year, which was very successful. Our enrollment has really, really grown. And we are having an event on this coming Saturday evening. And I'll let Ms. Vicki explain that when she comes up. I'll let her explain that. But anyway, I am also the chair of Pamlico Youth Development Community Organization, and we do partner with the school, and we partner with Pamlico Progressive, and we are doing great things. Also, we partner with Parkworks. So we're doing great things in the county. We're trying to enhance our membership. We're granted members here from the PIDCO, all the NAACP. Would you please stand? There we go. Oh, yes. I'll let Sandra tell you about the forum. We thank God for that. And Ms. Vicki is going to come now and tell about the Women of the Year, the Woman of the Year.
Yes, we're having a Mother of the Year, Woman of the Year contest pageant on this Saturday, June 2nd. At 6 o'clock here in this facility. And it is a fundraiser for the NAACP. We have five contestants, five women who are vying for that title, and it is a fundraiser. And tickets are $15, and it comes with a meal. We're asking that you please partner with us and come out and join us on Saturday at 6 o'clock.
Hi, I'm Sandra Hawkins. The forum will be on June 18th. We're trying to inform the public of what we can do as NAACP. What we can do, we cannot get someone out of jail. We can handle their civil rights if it's needed, civil or social injustice. And we're inviting the public to come and at the Newbert East Missionary Baptist Association Tabernacle at between 5 and 7 on June 18th to let you know more about what we're doing. We'd like to invite anybody who would like to join us, such as the Sheriff's Department, to let us know our rights and how to behave when when you're arrested. Thank you.
Good morning. I'm Darrell Gibbs, and I'm the president of CIG, Citizens Involved in Government. Some of the things that we're involved in, and these are some of the members. We're involved in financial responsibility, disaster preparedness, disaster aftermath, how to read and do financial paperwork. Also, the community, the elderly, aftermath disaster. If there's a hurricane and our community don't know where to go to get help, if your house flood or you lose your home, period, where do you go to get help? This board is the place you can come to. We can tell you where to go at and how to get help. Also, we do a Martin Luther King program each year. It's the third weekend in January. And the last 2 years, we've had the program here, and it's been a great success. We had a lot of people turn out, and I hope you all will come this year, because believe me, it makes a big difference when you're doing the right thing in the community. And I encourage everyone to smile more. Trust me, you'll feel much better.
I was really blessed. So we do meet every second Monday night at the Senior Service Building, NAACP. Thank you.
My name is Philip Lewis. I pastor the Lowland Pentecostal Holiness Church. Pleasure to be here today. I'm going to give this to my executive assistant, my sister. She'll be telling you what we're doing here in the county.
I just heard so many good things today, and I feel very insignificant because it's not that we really had anything up. It's just that we helped. So when I did, I made a list, and I'll make it as brief as I can. How many of you know Lynn Lewis? She's our registered deeds. She's a member of our church, and so she introduces us to a lot of the things that are going on in the county. And so what I'm going to tell you is some of those things she's introduced us to. She couldn't be here today. She's helping her mom, which is a wonderful thing to do. Good thing she's got a daughter, right? All right. And so we do, I'm going to start with children. The school backpacks, she introduced us to that. We've been working in that for since 2012. Leon also introduced us to this past Sunday to a new program that's being launched called Love Thy Neighbor. So we've already donated to that to help feed the hungry and those who need lunches during the summertime. She also introduced us to Operation Veggie, which she works in. Another member of our church also helps us with that. She did a wonderful job in doing Thank You Vet last week. How many of you know about that? And so we're just so proud that she's a member of our church that introduces us to so many things. I want to tell you one more thing that we do from our church. We also take care of children. We do 5 children in the missionary program all over the world that we keep going through for many years. And so we really feel and have a heart for reaching out to children. And so we also do that. And then Bibles. We participate in helping graduates get Bibles. We also reach out with the Gideons, although we don't have members of the Gideons in our church. We also have them in periodically. We help that. And then at Christmas time, we also help send Bibles for our veterans as well. Other community things that we do. We used to do Meals on Wheels, but the storms after we had Irene in 2011, we just didn't have enough people to actually merit the program, keep them coming. But we did do that. But tell you what our church did do. We did have some elderly people that were still left there, and we have fed them ourselves, made sure they had hot meals from our church, which is a wonderful blessing to do. We've done that. Then our elderly, we also, for our both nursing homes, we remember them at Easter, Mother's Day, Father's Day, Christmas. We actually get together at our church and we just do little gifts, and yes, our men even do up the ribbons for us and help us do all that. And that's a real blessing that we do that. At Christmas time, we find families that we don't even know. They're identified through the schools or somebody that we don't know. We try to help those as well. But let me tell you, the one thing that we do most at Lowland, faith without works is dead. And works without faith, it just won't work. And so in all the work, and all you people that you've been up here, and I hear the wonderful thing, I had no idea all these burdens were going on in Capitol County. But without God, nothing will be successful. And so that's the thing that we do at Lowland the most, is that we try to pray for our children, our elderly, our troops, and keep God at the head of our church, and love people. He makes a difference in our lives. I have a little saying, I just want to say this, that I sit on my desk all the time, and it says this: to the world, you may be one person, but to one person, you may be the world. And I look at all you people here today, and I see that's what you are. That's what you are, making a difference in people's lives. Thank you for being here.
If I can call some more organizations to come up on deck. Girl Scouts of North Carolina, Coastal Pines, Pimlico County, Girls on the Run, Friends of the Pimlico County Library, Focus Therapy Services, Fishes and Loaves Food Pantry, East Carolina Workforce Development Board, Donnie Gray Ambulance Fund, the Croker Festival, the County Compass, and if we missed you at all, if you feel that you're in that category, feel free to come on deck. I also want to say, if you're coming up this part of the building, we do have a cord coming to the camera now, so please be careful you don't trip. Actually, last week at this time, we projected that we would have 80 people attend, and we've more than doubled it, and so our battery has gone out, and the camera, we don't want to miss anyone, so we now have a cord, but please be careful. So, thanks.
Well, good morning, everybody. My name is Albert Almore, and I serve as the campus pastor at Latitude Church here in Pimlico. Right now, we meet every Sunday at Pimlico High School. And let me tell you guys, I am red, bull, excited to be in Pimlico County. I want to tell you guys, thank you guys for those that have reached out and have welcomed us with welcome, open arms and open hearts and prayers. On behalf of Latitude Church, we want to tell you thank you. Thank you for the love. Thank you for the support. There is one key word that I keep hearing here, and that word is collaboration. I am a firm believer that collaboration is greater than competition. Collaboration is greater than competition. Every Sunday morning, as hundreds of churches in Pimlico County are gathering together along with us to lift up the name of Jesus, the name that is still above every name, the name that's above everything that tries to oppose us. Even though there are many, many churches that meet every Sunday or every other Sunday in this area, there are still countless souls that are not in any of our churches. And that's our focus, to collaborate together, to reach them before we have to rescue them. God bless you guys, and I look forward to the collaboration.
Can you hear me?
Yep.
I'm Diane McDaniel. I am president of the board of Hospice of Pimlico. This is Tanya Jordan. She is our director of the program and also one of our nurses. We are here to take care of the terminally ill at home. We are free of charge to all of our clients. We don't turn anyone down. And we can do this because of the generosity of the county and the donations that you have given to us to help us to have the best department store in Pimlico County. Thank you for your support, and if we can be of service to any of you, please let us know.
Hi, my name is Cecily Lomar. I'm this year's board chair for Hope Clinic. Most of you are used to seeing Sherry Ratu, our renowned executive director in this position, speaking with you. She couldn't make it today, and it's taken four of us to replace her, so that gives you an idea of how important she is to all of us at Hope Clinic. Again, most of you are familiar with Hope Clinic. I'm not going to take too much time speaking about that, but I do want to just emphasize the really important work that we do. We see the patients in this community who, as I call it, fall through the cracks in our system. They don't make enough to pay for insurance, they make too much, or even, believe it or not enough to qualify for Medicaid. So they're right in that spectrum of the economic spectrum to not being able to provide care for themselves, health care. Most of them have some kind of a chronic disease, which really adds to the financial burden. They might have diabetes, they might have hypertension, they might have COPD, or in the case of many of them, they have all three of those. And so Hope Clinic is able to provide medical care for those to make sure they can maintain their lifestyle and work if they're able to work. Many of our patients work. At the same time, we provide some really life-saving medications, insulin being the number one obvious choice for those who are diabetic. This year, we've started a new program that we are very, very excited about. You've all already heard a number of organizations talk about the opioid epidemic in our county. We were able to work with a number of the agencies in Pamlico County this year and start the one and only medication assisted opioid treatment program. It's called New Beginnings. We started last September. We haven't even been open a year so far. We're doing some tremendous work. We provide physician-supervised medication. We provide support groups, access to counseling services for people in our community who are addicted to opioids. We've been working very closely with Sheriff Davis and the jail to make sure people coming through the jail who are addicts are able to get started on the program if they so choose. I have with me today Daryl Gibbs, one of our board members. He's on multiple boards, but he does share his time with us with some hope. Yolanda Cristiani behind me, she's our clinic coordinator. And then I do want to introduce Sandy Allen, right behind me, to just talk a little bit about some of the things that New Beginnings is doing, because it really is a very exciting program, and I don't think there's one person in this room who has not been touched in one way or another by the opioid or the addiction epidemic.
Good morning. So the program is free, which is number one in the nation. We are actually being looked at as a model for other programs to start. Generally in a week, I talk to at least, at the minimum, five new people. Either parents, husbands, wives, or the person that's battling addiction themselves. If any of your groups would like for me to come speak to them about the program, I'd be happy to come speak to you. The one thing I want to tell you that we do have is we have seven meetings. They meet every night of the week, 7 to 8. They're 12-step meetings, and in the last 2 months, we've implemented 5 new meetings, some during the day. We're trying to build life skills. So if some of you are those that are wanting to collaborate for life skills, I would love to have you connect with me so that we can get some more programs started. My folks are now getting jobs. They're beginning to pour back into the community. So I would love to just talk to you guys about what we're doing in the program. Thank you.
Thank you very much. We know that throughout this room, you are making such a difference in changing lives, and this is a great example of organizations that are saving lives. So.
Good morning. I'm Karen Prince. I'm the Executive Director of HeartWorks, and I am thrilled today to be able to introduce not only some of our board members, but HeartWorks founders and creators, Dr. Sue and Rod Lee. We also have board members Deborah Steenson and Jim Reagan. You've probably all seen HeartWorks, our facility next door to Wells Fargo, or the big white building with the fenced-in property. We are, the highlight of our year has been that we are serving now almost 500 youth and their families each year through some service of some sort. We have 3 major programs. HeartWorks began in 2002 with a licensed therapeutic counseling program, which is still in operation today and is actually booming. Our counselors see almost 200 clients a year, the vast majority of whom are 3 to 17-year-olds. And most of those juveniles are seen in the school setting so that their parents don't have to travel to get them to appointments and such. Our second and now biggest program is our after school and summer program for kindergarten through eighth grade kids, students. We are we're currently in the 9th year of a 21st Century Community Learning Center grant cycle, which allows us to provide 3 hours a day during the school year of very advanced services to 150 kindergarten through eighth grade students every day. We also, through this same grant program, are able to provide 11 hours a day of programming to 100 of those students during the summer months. This has been just a tremendous program, and we think it's very beneficial to the community. And we need volunteers. I see a lot of volunteers out there, but if you're not already and would like to, please contact us at HeartWorks. Catherine Hudson, who also is on our board, is our volunteer coordinator, and she'd be glad to talk to you. Our third and youngest program at HeartWorks is our five-star daycare for 1 to 5 year old kids. We're currently full, which is wonderful, with a waiting list, but we provide excellent and exquisite educational and caring services for the kids in the county. If you're interested, come out and see us. We're there pretty much every day. So thank you very much.
I'd just like to say I had the pleasure of touring HeartWorks. What you're doing is miraculous, and it's making such a difference with the kids of our community.
Hi, I'm back. Tony Santori. I'm the president of the board of, for Habitat for Humanity. This is Sue Adams, my vice president. Most people know Habitat for Humanities is in the business of building affordable housing for people. We've run through a major disaster here in the last couple of weeks, as you see our Restore burnt down. But fortunately, it will not impair us from building these two houses, and we're ready to break ground for two families in Pamlico on new housing. What we could use, people have been calling us and asking us, you know, what can we do, what can we do? Right now, you could do a cash donation, which would be really fine. And that can send it to Habitat for Humanities, P.O. Box 3, Grantsboro, North Carolina. We will tell you as soon as we have a new building where you can start bringing back furniture. But right at this point in time, we're safe. We have enough money to build the two houses. We just do not have any new revenue coming in until we open the roof store. I'm looking for volunteers for building houses. We need anybody who knows how to swing a hammer. If you need one to volunteer, you can call me personally at 252-204-5785. That's 252-204-5785. Anybody can swing a hammer.
I just want to say that one of the houses we're building is for one of a former Pamlico Community College student. So that's a wonderful thing.
All right. Thank you very much.
Condition, formerly Host Chapel Elementary School, built in 1920, closed in 1963, and it has been in use since 1971. We are very proud to be at Rosenwald School. Rosenwald Schools are built, there were 800 built in North Carolina, four in Pamlico County, and we are one of the four, but the only one in usable condition at this time. Through grants and your generous donations, we were able to replace the joints and seals in our building and serve as an outreach location for the Old Front Porch Musical Festival. We had Melissa Doolittle there May of last year. And this year we're going to host another outreach in Rangitani. And on June 23rd, we are going to sponsor another cleanup day. We will have all of you who want to help come out and help us clean up. And we're going to have fish. Free fish for those who don't clean up, selling fish for those who don't want to help. So you're welcome to be one of those people. Behind me I have Phyllis Beasley, our assistant secretary, and Neville Clement, our assistant project managers. Doug Sias Vaughn, I think he's our project manager. I want to tell you, when you see a room full of mixed people like we have right here today, and a little old school like Host Chapel, it makes your heart bleed because you know people are really caring about each other. This was a predominantly black school. No, it was a black school. And we feel that room was 60% black, 40% white, and vice versa. And we got in there, and let me tell you something, we had a good time. Those folks work, they clean, and they teach. So, on June 23rd, you have that same opportunity. Come out there. We are a community. A community. And we would like for you to be part of that community. Thank you.
Good morning, neighbors. Was that loud enough? Thanks, Dr. Ross, for all your effort in putting this together. Gene Lupton here from the Goose Creek Island Community Development Incorporated. I'm not going to be here long. I've only got a minute, so I got to talk fast. We are an organization that was started in 1969 at Hoboken. If you've been to Hoboken lately and look up on the hill, you will see that large building that we maintain there. And we use this building for community efforts to better our community. We also rent it out. Weddings, showers, birthday parties, all that kind of stuff. Right now we're in an effort to replace some of the equipment in the playground over the last 20 years in the storms. It has wiped out some of our equipment. I have Ms. Hazel Alcock with me this morning. She's worked with us very, very close with the center. And she has recently developed a paper that has been submitted to get some money to do that. But anyway, it's good to be here with you. And let me mention two more quick things. Every Thursday morning, right now, at 10 o'clock, The 55 Plus Club meets at the center. You're welcome to go to that. And also, don't forget, in October, each October, the third week, we have our annual play. And then the third Sunday, we have our combined church service. So come on up to Hoboken, take a look around, come visit, and thank you very much.
She's the pantry supervisor of the same organization. We've been working together now 10 years. We have just celebrated our 10th anniversary providing food to those in need in Pamlico County. We actually have four programs. Alyssa is in charge of the one, which is located at St. Peter the Fisherman in White Farm Road in Oriental. The food pantry serves approximately 275-280 regular clients a month. These are people who qualify in terms of need, and they come on a designated day to pick up approximately 1 week's worth of non-perishables, vegetables, fruit, dairy products, meat, personal hygiene items. And then we also have a program that's kind of allied with that, which is like emergency referrals. These are people who may come in once a month as needed. They don't come on a regular basis. So Liz does that program. We have two other programs, food related, on the first Wednesday of every month. We have a really large truck that comes from the Food Bank of Central and Eastern North Carolina in Greenville. And on that truck are perishable items, which we distribute to anybody who comes to the parking lot at St. Peter the Fisherman at that time. The other program Alyssa's program reaches about 300 to 325 a month. The truck that I just mentioned, another 100. And then the fourth program is outreach to community churches. Those perishable products, those products which will not keep for very long, we are able to get those out to 16 different community churches throughout the county. That includes meat, vegetables, fruit, produce, bread, pastries, that kind of thing. I want to quickly mention, I see so many people in the audience here, some of whom have left, who have helped us in the past. And we do rely on volunteers, primarily private donations. We also have a board of directors with representatives from Arapahoe United Methodist Church, Bayborough United Methodist Church, Bethany Christian Church, First Baptist Church of Oriental, Oriental Rotary Club, Oriental United Methodist Church, Pamlico United Methodist Church, Stonewall United Methodist Church, St. Peter the Fisherman Catholic Church, and St. Thomas Episcopal Church. Without them, we really couldn't do what we've done. I think someone counted, we have distributed over 3 million pounds of food over the course of about 8 years. Thank you.
We're also looking for volunteers, and the pay is good, I'll tell you. I get the same thing, and I get zero. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good morning. As a physical education teacher, everybody stand up. Come on, stand up. Raise your arms, sway to the right, sway to the left. Woo, take a deep breath. Did that make you feel better? I am the executive director of the Croker Festival, coming up very, very soon. And the Croker Festival was started years ago, 38 to be exact, by the Oriental Women's Club for nonprofit organizations. A venue where you can show your wares if you sell something, or if you want to cook something and have a bake sale, or if you wanted to have a raffle or something as a fundraiser for you. We are now accepting vendors, so I am pleading to you, if you have an organization that you want to give information out, please give us a contact. Information booth is $75, but we'll work with you. We know that there's a lot of organizations that really don't get a lot of money, so we work with you any way we can to give you a venue to show who you are and what you do for our community. And Dr. Ross, I would like to thank you for inviting us. June the 29th, 30th, 1st, July 1st, and 2nd this year will be the Kroger Festival. And you say, well, normally it's 2 days. And it is. The big day is the 29th. Opening ceremonies start at 4 o'clock all day Saturday and Saturday night. This year we have the Embers coming. And even as a high school kid, this shows how old the Embers are. I wanted the Embers to come to Oriental. They were the best band on the East Coast. Well, I got them. So they will be here on the 30th at 7:30. So come on out. And then also, we also have a beautiful fireworks celebration to end Saturday night. On Sunday, 10 o'clock in the morning, is a community church service at the park. And then you're on your own for Sunday afternoon. But then shine up your golf shoes, and it doesn't matter whether you know how to play or not. Just come on out and play with us. We're having our first annual golf tournament at Minnesota. So it's a captain's choice, so anybody can play. So come on out and have some fun on July the 2nd. So hope to see you. Call me.
Director for Girls on the Run of Pamlico County. I see some familiar faces out here. We have people who've donated socks. Thank you very much for our Girls on the Run, who have sponsored girls who are unable to pay their registration fee and contributed time as running buddies and been supporters of this wonderful organization that's been in Pamlico County since the year 2009. For those of you who are not familiar with it, it's not a running program, although many of our girls do participate in sports such as the track team. Our first class of Girls on the Run, we have a couple of girls who are now in college, and they come back as junior coaches. Girls on the Run is, as I said, not a sports program, but rather a youth development program. There's a curriculum, it's in all 50 states, couple provinces in Canada even. And its purpose is to empower girls. In Pamlico County, we currently serve girls grades 3, 4, and 5. We meet at Fred Anderson Elementary 2 afternoons after school, where the girls learn how wonderful they are, no matter what size, shape package they come in, that they're unique and that they're wonderful. They learn healthy living habits. They learn how to be a good friend. They learn how to combat bullying. Instead of being a bystander, they've learned to become a standby her. They also learn that they are a part of the community. Just like all of us here today are part of the community and giving back. We have 8-year-old little girls, 9-year-old little girls, 10 and 11-year-old little girls who give back to the community. For instance, this past season, their community impact project was to collect personal hygiene items for the women at the Coastal Women's Shelter. And they presented it with joy in their heart and smiles on their faces and realizing that they too can make a difference. Now you ask, why is it called Girls on the Run? We actually do run. And every year we have 2 sessions during the school year, one in the fall and then one in the spring. And it culminates with a 5K fun run. Not a 5K race, because as I said, it's non-competitive. But instead it's a celebration with their family, their friends, and former Girls on the Run, and they run their hearts out, they walk their hearts out, and they skip their hearts out around the Pamlico County High School track. We would love to expand this program to get back into the middle schools where it could really be of a great assistance, and to extend it and get it back into the Arapahoe Charter School, or maybe even at Fred Anderson Elementary on alternate days. The only way that this can happen, however, is by expanding our coaching staff. Our board of directors and our